everyone. Myself, I'm Uma, and I have overall 8+ years of IT experience as a data analyst and 4 years of experience as a corporate trainer. I'm a Microsoft certified data analyst and a corporate trainer and currently working at Microsoft. Hello, everyone. Welcome to KSR Data Vizion YouTube channel. I am back today with one more use case. So already I have posted two more use cases, like two more real-time interview scenarios. If you have not watched that, you can check it from the playlist or the description box. And this is the third use case, okay? So in this use case, they are asking us to calculate the business days or working days between order date and delivered date. So this is the real-time interview scenario, okay? It was asked in one of the big four company. So let's see how we can achieve this. So whenever a use case or a requirement is given, the first step will be analyzing the data. So what is the data? This is the table which we have loaded. So the data looks like this. So here we have order ID, order date, deliver date, and ship mode. It means some orders have been placed. So when the order is placed and when the order is delivered to the customer, and ship mode is nothing but based on the order, like same day delivery or standard class delivery, second class delivery. So based on the number of days taken to deliver the product. So this is how the table looks like. And what is the question given by the interviewer? It is to calculate the business days or working days. Means we have to exclude the non-working days like Saturdays and Sundays. Okay. Or in between any holidays or optional holiday or any business holidays, we need to exclude that. So let's see how we can achieve this one. So first thing, I'll create a table now. In this, I will add order ID. Then I will add order date. So it is in this hierarchy. I don't want this. I'll show order date. And then I'll add this delivery date. This also, I want it as delivered date. So now I have to show them the number of business days or working days. So let's achieve this using DAX function. Okay. Let me take this. I'll create one new measure. So now working days. Okay. Let's take this measure as working days or net means overall working days. So now let's start writing the logic. Okay. Alt enter. So I'll take two variables. Okay. Because I want this value to be dynamic whenever in the report, if they are selecting any order date or deliver date, it should be dynamic. So I am taking this selected value function. Selected value. What is that? First one, I will take order date. Okay. I'm taking this order date and then again alt enter. I will take one more variable where I'm storing the value of selected value. Here I'm storing the value of delivered date and then again alt enter for moving to the next line. Now I want to see the business days, right? So I'll take one more variable, business days equal to. Now I'll be introducing a new function. Okay. It is nothing but network days, net working days. Network days is nothing but net working days. So this is nothing but a new function which was released by Microsoft recently. Few months back they have released this function. So it is nothing but network days. It gives the overall net working days or business days excluding the non-working days and holidays. If you read the description here, you will understand. Return the number of whole work days between the two dates, including two dates like start date and end date we will be passing now. So including those 2 days, it will give the overall working days using parameters to indicate which and how many days are weekend days. Weekend days and any days that are specified as holidays or not considered as work days means holidays also it will exclude. So it is asking now 2 dates, right? Start date and end date. So this weekend and holidays, these are optional, which is given in these brackets, right? So this we will exclude and we will pass these 2 parameters, which is start date and end date. So my start date is nothing but order date. So order date already I have stored in the variable A. So I am passing the variable A and delivered date I have stored in variable B. So I am passing this alt enter. Now I have to return this value. What is that? Business days. And select this one and click on enter. Now this is done. This is down. Now this measure has been created. So this is my table now, where you can see the orders placed. These are each order has some unique ID and when it is ordered and when it is delivered to the customer. Now let's see how many working days it took between this order date and delivered date. So let me drag and drop this measure which we have created now to this table. If you see here, between 20th September 2022 to 26th September 2022, it took 5 working days to deliver this product. Okay, so let's test this one. Let's test this. Let's go to the calendar. Let's go to September month. So when it is ordered? 20th. So it is ordered on 20th September. And then it is delivered on 26th September. So we have to include both the days. It is inclusive in the formula, you would have read, right? Including the start date and end date means this order date and deliver date. So we have to consider both the days, 20 and 26. And then in between these two, we will be excluding the Saturdays and Sundays. So Saturday and Sundays are nothing but 24th and 25th. 24th and 25th we are excluding, and let's start the count. This 20 is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, exclude this 2, and 26th is 5. So in between 20 and 26, we got overall 5 working days. So our measure has also returned the same. Let's see one more test. Let's test one more, okay? So here the order date is 4th September 2022 and this is 8th September 2022. So this is the 4th September, it is ordered, and 8th September it is delivered to the customer. So as per our formula, we need to include both, right? Start date and end date. But in this case, we are excluding this because it is a weekend, right? Non-working day. So I'm excluding this one. And then I'm taking the count. 5th, 6th, 7th and 8th. So start date is 4th and this one is 8th. So I'm excluding this and I'm only taking 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th. So the resultant is 4. So this is correct. So in the formula also, whatever we have given in this formula, if you want to change, right, like the business working days, if you feel that for some people it is like Monday, Tuesday will be a holiday, it is non-working day, then you can give that parameters accordingly. So in detailed about the network days function, you can go to this Microsoft documentation and you can read about this. So if you want to change, right, in by default, it is taking Saturday and Sunday as an weekdays, means non-working days. So if you want to change that date to Sunday and Monday as a non-working day or different dates, then you have to pass these values accordingly, 2, 3, 4, these values accordingly. So in detailed about this network days function, you can read it from here because this is recently introduced function. So this is how you can calculate. You can create variables, and since I want this dynamically, whenever any user wants to select this order date and deliver date, then so for dynamic, I have used this selected value, and then I am passing these two variables in the network days function and I am returning that. So this is how you can calculate the number of working days or business days between two dates, okay? So similarly, if they come up with some other use case, the concept, hope you would have understood this concept. Not only using this function, we can achieve this, calculate this business days using multiple ways, okay? If you also know some other ways or other methods in achieving the same, then please do reply in the comment box. Any other logics or any other suggestions you want to provide, then please update in the comment box, and hope this is useful to you. Let's see what all the questions we have covered from this scenario. So in interview, either they will give some use case similar to this, they will show the data to you, they will just give this data to you, and then they will ask you to create the logic for implementing this business days or working days. This is how we can achieve. So what are the other questions they may ask from this scenario? Means What is this network DAZ function? What is this DAX function? How it works? In detailed about this function, they will ask. So you can go to this documentation once. This I will provide in the description box. You read it once, okay, in detailed about this function. And then similarly, they may ask that selected value, how this selected value function works in DAX. That also we have used in this measure. Same thing, if you want to learn in detailed about the function, then I will recommend you to learn from this Microsoft documentation. So every DAX function in detailed about the function, you can see that in the documentation part. You can read it from the same. Similar to network DAZ, you can search with this function also and you can read it from there. And next, same concept, they may change the use case, okay? They might ask, calculate the working days between project start date and project end date. Project start date and end date. So they will give, they may give a table with the all the projects, list of projects, when it started and when it ended. And they might ask you to calculate the working days in in the each project, how many working days they took, how many days it took, business days or working days to complete that project. So same concept. In this, you will be using the same thing. And you will, instead of order date, it will be project start date. Instead of deliver date, it will be project end date. And same concept. You will be using the same function, same logic. And even if they ask you, they twist the use case or they ask you a different use case, then also you can answer once you learn the concept. So hope this session is useful to you. Stay tuned for more such videos and please do like, share and subscribe to KSR Data Vizion YouTube channel for more such informative videos. Thank you.